bumps taking pictures.
And we over here, we can go anywhere around the world. Because niggas go everywhere, right? Niggas is a talent, right? That's what Jay-Z ever told you?
Yeah. You will never jinx us.
But y'all wanna go to Africa and grab your nuts and go see what's up with the diamond mines, won't you?
Never jinx us, you will never rest in peace, chinx us. We run with guards and the rich niggas. Never need rides when you fly this high. Unarmed profits always die.
They basically gave the European power when they came over here was the rifle. They said that the Europeans shot thunder. If I didn't introduce myself to you, my name is Rashid. Alright? You can call me Rashid. That's cool. Okay, that's what it is. The brother's deep, he's also a artist. As well as a music artist. This guy's like a Renaissance man. He's a student and a teacher. The brother's also a clothing designer, and he also has a prime time network for the listening audience on the internet, on the Blog Talk Radio show. He's gonna tell you about, but he has a show called Nova Ledge that's aired internationally on every Tuesday and Friday nights. He's going to tell you more about it, right? And a lot of awesome speakers come there and talk. So at any rate, put the warm black hands together and usher up our brother, the Red Pillar. His name is the Red Pillar. Usher him up.
Greetings, greetings, everybody. Welcome to the presentation, Hip Hop 2012 Summit. My name is Brother Red Pillar. Today, we're going to be going into a lecture dealing with some of the subjects that have been popping up in the news lately. Most importantly, we're going to talk about Tupac. By show of hands, how many people are familiar with Tupac Shakur? Like I said, the Incan King Tupac Amaru was killed by the conquistadors, right? Tupac Amaru was the last of the royal family of the Incan Empire to ever actually rule his people. After the Spanish invasion of the Andes, many of his family members were killed, including his uncles, Atahualpa and Huáscar. Those two people right there were murdered by a conquistador by the name of Pizarro. I really encourage the family to do the history of Pizarro. Google Pizarro, do it. Please find out about that, the history of how they robbed Peru for all of his gold and how they enriched Europe.
Spell it,
Pizarro, P-I-Z-Z-A-R-O. That's where you get pizza from. The Pizarros were grand murderers. They were murderers on, they talk about Hitler and all of that. These people were murderers on a scale never seen before. They wiped out, millions upon millions of so-called indigenous people in the Americas. Both of whom were kings of separate parts of a divided empire when the Spanish arrived. By 1570, keep in mind with these years, 1570, because they tell you that you were slaves in 1570, you weren't doing nothing. You were just picking cotton, saying, yes, sir, yes, ma'am, and scratching your head and all of that. But meanwhile, in the Americas, they had cities of gold. The gold that they took from this empire is the gold that made European the rich country that it, the Europe, the rich country that it is today. In the basement of the Vatican, forget Fort Knox. In the basements of the Vatican, in the basements, because all of that gold went back to the church. All of that gold went back to the crowns and kings. You see Queen Elizabeth walking around with all of them diamonds? There are no diamonds in Europe. Europe, the only two continents that are barren of diamonds is Antarctica and Europe. They don't grow no diamonds in the ground. So all of the big nuggets that they got, the whole diamond and all of that shit, they stole that from your people.
I would get it on. Forget about it, huh? Listen, man, I'm not gonna waste any more of my time with you.
Time.
You wanna deal with the Lord, you deal with us later, you understand?
Later. Why should I do something later when I can do it now?
Because I told you.
So all the big nuggets that they got, the whole diamond and all of that shit, they stole that from your people. And they running around, you know, blinging, showing it off, like, you know, what you gonna do about it? By 1570, and niggas is dying for pinky rings. Niggas is dying for cubic zirconias in the street. That shit is disgusting. You know what I mean? And you got places in Africa right now that these Europeans is over there Ben done told you? That y'all wanna go to Africa and grab your nuts and go see what's up with them diamond mines, won't you? You just wait for Akon to do it. But Akon got a diamond mine, he bought it. But you won't go over there and see what's popping with your shit. But you African, right? I'm talking to you. By 1570, only a small remote outpost remained of Inca rule in the Peruvian jungles of Vicabamba.